Brooch to perfect.
A little different.
And today's newspaper just delivered.
We are Thanks, going Codsworth. To do
of course,
some ASMR.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle Gaming. Of the Bat Babies.
You'll have to let me know if More this is same. Quiet enough. So do let me know down in the comments, okay? We are playing Fallout 4. I am playing this with Mark.
I shall attend.
We will be playing with Sims.
I know we were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Codsworth.
And some assorted other mods for weapons, etc.
Never gonna find that dog.
The difference between this playthrough and the playthrough on my gaming channel is going to be that for the first time ever on this playthrough, we will be choosing to stay with the Institute.
All the easier for our mechanized Hellcats to drive any screen.
So that should be interesting.
That salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering you.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again.
Why, we're about you, ma'am. And helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Then I'm glad I opened the door.
Oh, me too. You have no idea. Now I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being, a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault.
And thank
vault
goodness we
111.
But I have a family. You can fit us all, right?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally. In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Tell me more about this vault.
Oh, it has all the amenities of the modern home, I assure you. Not to mention total protection from nuclear radiation and hostile mutants. A better future underground. It's not only our mission, it's our passion.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see.
All right, for this build, we are going to go for a more well-rounded sort of build. We're gonna put our emphasis, a small one, onto luck and charisma.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Oh, baby Christ.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that maternal affection you seem to be so good at.
Go ahead, honey. I'll be there in a second to help, okay?
All right, let's go check on the baby. Hi, baby.
My boy isn't giving his mother any trouble, is he? Hey, I fixed that mobile on his crib the other day. Why don't you give it a spin?
Okay, let's try it.
That's my boy, on his best behavior, just like his dad. Well, most of the time, anyway. Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Sure.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by... yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations.
Oh no.
We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Codsworth. Stay safe, honey. We need to get to the vault. Now!
I got Sean. Let's go.
And here we go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
We'll drive them close. That's gotta be wrong.
Hold on, little guy.
All participants this way.
You don't get
in. I'm going in. You can't stop me.
Oh. We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant. Adult male. Adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck, sir.
Follow me. Come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Now keep moving.
No, they're not.
He's fine. We're gonna be okay. I love you.
Oh my God!
Hold on!
Boo.
Oh God! Oh God! Oh God!
Wow.
Did it. You made it. We're okay.
Yes.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No.
We'd all be.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Up we go. All new residents, please proceed in an orderly fashion.
Male.
Welcome home.
Female.
This one's good.
Step over to the table, take a seat.
Oh,
welcome. Pick up a suit right over there. This way, please. Right over there, please.
Here
just
you are.
Step over to
head
the
down
table.
The hall.
Just
there.
This way. Over
yeah,
there.
Looks
take
fine.
A suit.
You'll need your suits before we can take you further. Thanks.
Our vault suit.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
Such cute baby sounds.
This is our new home.
Take a vault suit, then head down the hall.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you. It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
It's a good fit, don't you think?
The vault
suit. Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Prepared for the future, right?
Right. Prepared for the future.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
Okay.
It'll be okay.
That does not
Mommy's right
look
here.
Like
See?
A decontamination
Who's
chamber.
My little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There she is, see? Mommy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
Hey!
Just step into the chamber. Take your time. We've got all day.
Here we go.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Come on, come on. Oh, God. I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
All right. The only pod you can open is that of your wiper husband.
Must vacate immediately.
once tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment for a better future or something. I don't know. It just doesn't seem right that we were smiling at them all that time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have said or told them something? Christmas Underground got together with the rest of the security boys and support staff and had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy lad snack cake that wasn't too stale. None of the scientists came. Overseer wasn't there either. I just don't get them. They hiding something from us. Another company secret, only for the higher-ups. Whatever. Just a few more months until the all-clear is supposed to come through. Then we can start rebuilding. Only a few weeks left in our mandatory shelter period. Everyone's getting stir crazy. Some people are even saying the all clear signal is never coming. We can't stay here much longer, that's for sure. It's not just the fact that I've been staring at the same break room and bunk bed for over 6 months. It's the fact that we only have enough food left for another few months. Tops. The overseer keeps telling everyone to be patient and focus on work. He's definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad is going on. I just know it. The main door accessing the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the overseer's evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He has one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from a little makeshift checkpoint. Got invited to a meeting tonight. Support staff and security only. Sounds like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. No all clear from Vault Deck is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. I almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. A handful of us confronted the overseer about opening up the vault. I never knew a man that small could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in the office along with the rest of the science staff. We're supposed to hand over any food, weapons, and medicine we have by tonight. Or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everyone. It's time. One way or another, we're getting out of this vault. Vault 111. Is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Security staff are responsible installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties, insubordination, or interference with vault operations are capital offenses. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force.
Citizens must vacate immediately.
Giant roaches? What the hell?
Exactly what you want to see, right? When you wake up out of cryo, after nuclear war. Giant roaches.
What happened here?
That's the doctor.
Where is everyone?
Okay. Well, we read the first part of this. My latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no from Vault Deck. All personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of Vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the Vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcibly by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. Members of the research team must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary and cognitive activity in particular must be recorded hourly. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension, and must not interrupt suspension. Independent research is encouraged and left to the overseer discretion. Security patrols are to be carried out on a constant 8-hour rotation. Security priorities include monitoring for signs of intrusion, checking for atmosphere leaks, settling disputes among personnel, enforcement of regulations set forth by the overseer. Enforcement of regulations set forth by Vault Deck. Nature of Vault 111, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside of their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. The exact distribution of these roles is left to overseer discretion. Following a nuclear event, Vault Deck will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all-clear notice. Upon receiving the all-clear notice, Vault Deck personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault Deck, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault Deck will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault Deck, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstance may Vault 111 staff evacuate during the shelter period unless receiving the all-clear message. Strange issue today with pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. I'll have to keep an eye out. I only hope their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. There's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter. Supplies were never intended to last much more than that. And despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until the all-clear. Led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little we have left. I've been too damn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well,
coming back later for you.
Master Lock. See what else we can find. Some bobby pins. Maybe. Stim packs are always good.
Is this all that's left?
Brand new jumpsuit.
Is anyone alive? Did anyone get out?
Pip-Boy up his tab on the PC.
Oh, yeah.
So is that. All right. Three crates here with some goodies. This is another mod.
As I live and breathe, oh, it's really you.
Codsworth, you're still here. So, other people could still be alive too.
Well, of course I'm still here. Surely you don't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you seem the worse for wear. Best not let the hubby see you in that state, huh? Where is Sir, by the way?
Codsworth is such a sweetheart.
They came into the vault. Maybe you saw them. They had guns and strange outfits.
Only Miss Rose's boy running around in his Halloween costume more than a week early. I swear, the nerve of that woman leaving her brat unsupervised. Not like you, Mum. You're the perfect mother. And Sir is, where is Sir, by the by?
Well,
they killed him.
Oh, Mum, these things you're saying, these terrible things. I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps Shiraz. Oh, Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Well, no.
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm gonna find him. I'm gonna get my baby back.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
Two hundred years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, Mum. Give or take a little for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird.
Yeah,
what's wrong?
Mum, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house! And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mum. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe Sir was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
Well, listen.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? Sir and young Sean may turn up yet.
I'm whispering with a candy in my mouth.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, Mum. What's all this? Found you. Senses are picking up movement in another house.
They shoot their maggots at you.
Mom? Peek-a-boo!
Sweet.
I hope you don't mind me sucking on this candy.
Mom, your family isn't here either. They're really gone, aren't they?
Thanks for trying, Codsworth.
You can't give up, Mum. What about the city? Concord is nearby, and, well, the people there have only shot at me a few times.
Only a few times.
Thanks for your help, Codsworth.
Good luck, Mum. You'll find young Sean. I know you will.
I shall remain here and secure the home front.
Okay.
I think Sean and I need to tell you how great of a mother you are, but we're going to anyway. You were kind and loving and funny, that's right, and patient, so patient, patience of a saint, as your mother used to say. Look, with Sean and us all being at home together, it's been an amazing year, but even so, I know our best days are yet. There will be changes, sure. Things we'll need to adjust to. I'll rejoin the civilian workforce. You'll shake the dust off your law degree. But everything we do, no matter how hard, we do it for our family. Now say goodbye, Sean. Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Bye, honey. We love you.
So sad listening to that. All right, we are going to need to head towards Concord, but we're gonna make a few stops along. Station. Dog meat.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself? You lose your owner, buddy? Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Dog meat is in Fallout 1, 2, 3, is a female dog. I like to turn off the radio. Oh, dog meat wants me to come get this. Dog meat is the goodest boy. Some wrangling with the head office, but we finally got all the tools we need to machine our own parts. No more having to pay for Corvega factory parts. The next time they change the spec on a damn fastener, just take one we got, trim the excess down until it fits. Sanctuary Hills is restoring an old classic Corvega with her son. Nice woman. Pretty. Kid seems like kind of a brat. But I guess that's the point of her doing this project with him. Anyway, she's been doing a hell of a job. I was amazed at how much her and the kid have been able to do on their own. The only reason she even came to me is because the engine is out of her depth. I'm sure we can help her out. Jim, take care of these barrels before you leave tonight. Inspectors are coming first thing in the morning. Just hide them with the others. I'll figure out longer-term solution later. Hey, if nature's gonna favor us with a cave right below the shop, who am I to argue? Replace the brakes in 2075. Fusion, please, Supreme. The names of these cars are funny. Monthly service on the Vault-Tec van. No major issues with the vehicle. But that rep is an uppity asshole. Began work on a late model motorcycle. Pre-atomic. Seemed to be simply a sticky throttle. Turned out to be a more serious issue with the cables. They're almost all completely degraded. We'll replace with platinum parts. Coolant leak in one of those new 2077 Corvega Goo bubble top. They don't make them like they used to. Replace the atomic alternator in a 2073 Corvega. Thank you. is where all those mole rats came from. We're gonna collect all of this fungus. Thank you. can hear them up there. There's one right there. Sneaky guy.
Settlers inside. The raiders are almost through the door. Grab that laser musket and help us, please.
Preston. All right. I'm coming to help him. Yeah. All right. Let's put on some of that armor we picked up. Oh, actually, I've got raider light pieces. So good. Sure. Put on the vest and stuff under.
Man, I don't know who you are, but your timing's impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minuteman.
Huh. Nah, that ain't it.
Glad to help.
Well, if that's true, we could use some more goodwill. As you can see, we're in a bit of a mess here.
Maybe? Nope.
Who are these people?
Just folks looking for a new home, a fresh start. I've been with them since Quincy. Lexington looked good for a while, but the ghouls drove us out of there. A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. It's just me, the Longs, Marcy and June.
That's old Mama Murphy on the couch.
And this here is Sturgis.
Hey.
Ghouls? What are ghouls?
Wow. You really aren't from around here, are you? Ghouls are irradiated people. Most are just like you and me. They look pretty messed up and live for a long time, but they're still just people. The ones I'm talking about are different. The radiations rotted their brains, made them feral. They'll rip you apart just as soon as look at you. Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But, well, we do have one idea.
One good idea can make all the difference.
Sturgis?
Tell us. There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school. Pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
I like it.
Yeah, I thought you might. Protection with an added bonus. Get the suit, You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Minigun? Now we're talking.
I know, right? Only there's one hitch. The suit's out of juice. Probably been dry for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
I'll help if I can.
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when. And we know right where to find one.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement. Locked behind a security gate. Look, I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
Actually, I already grabbed the fusion core. We're set.
Well, all right. Maybe our luck's finally turning around. Once you jack the core into the power armor and grab that minigun, those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
Perfect.
I'll take that.
Careful, kid. There's something coming. And
nice.
And it's angry.
That is so creepy, Mama Murphy.
But we got somebody up here.
Later up on the ceiling there, see? On the roof.
Got anything?
Got him. Now we can use the minigun again.
Why don't you get down here? Show me that fancy gun up close. Got not a lot of people to get past my boys.
Take it easy, Mama. You okay?
I'm fine, Preston. Quit fussing.
That was a pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
You guys gonna be okay now?
Yeah, for a while anyway. We can at least move some. Listen, when we first met, you said you were glad to help. Well, you did. And we owe you our lives. So here, it ain't much, but it's the best way I can say thank you.
I didn't do it for the money.
Hey, sorry. I'm used to everyone being in it only for themselves. You know, you remind me of my friends. The other Minutemen. The ones who gave their lives for something bigger than themselves. You should come with us to Sanctuary. We could use the help.
All right, Garvey. I'm in.
Oh, that's wonderful. But there's more to your destiny, isn't there? I've seen it. And I know your pain.
Okay.
My destiny? What do you mean?
You are a woman out of time, out of hope. But all is not lost. I can feel your son's energy. He's alive.
Where is my son? Where is Sean?
Oh, I wish I knew, kid. I really do. But it's not like I can see your son. I can just feel his life force, his energy. He's out there. And even I don't need the sight to tell you where you should start looking. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Diamond City. The biggest settlement around.
What's in Diamond City? Is Sean there?
Look, kid, I'm tired now. Maybe you'll bring me some chems later. The sight will paint a clearer picture.
No, Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk, it's gonna kill you.
But shush, Preston, we're all gonna die eventually. We're gonna need the sight. And our new friend here, she's gonna need it too. Now let's get going. Sanctuary awaits.
All right, folks. Thanks to our friend here, it's safe to move out. We're heading for that place Mama Murphy knows about. Sanctuary. It's not far.
She knows about it? You mean she had one of her visions while she was stoned out of her gourd? And now you want us to just head out on another wild goose chase based on no better plan than Mama Murphy saw it?
It can hardly turn out any worse than...
Everybody just take it easy. We're all in this together, right? So Marcy, you got a better idea of what we should do next? Anybody?
Mercy is well, then, awful.
Sanctuary it is. Let's just hope it lives up to its name.
Come on, June. It's time to go.
Oh, okay.
And heading back out. Back to Sanctuary.
Behind you, boss.
We'll have time to loot the bodies on the way back. Because they walk slower than we do. Thank you. is restless.
Well, look at that. I think I just found my new vacation home.
Your idea of heaven, eh, Sturgis? Could be some good salvage in there. Let's get to Sanctuary first, though. I think we're close. Somewhere around Concord. That means this right here must be the old North Bridge, where the first shots of the American Revolution were fired. I'd call that the best omen I've seen since we left Quincy.
Yeah, I don't know what you're talking about, boss, but I'm glad you're happy about it.
I'm glad you decided to come with us. I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place to call home. What do you think?
Yep. Yeah. I used to like living here. Before the war.
What do you mean? Before what war? Are you saying...
I lived here. Over 200 years ago. I was frozen or something for most of it. I just woke up a little while ago.
Damn. Like one of those old pre-war ghouls. You say you were frozen. Anybody else make it out with you?
Just my son. Somebody took him away while I was still trapped. Have you run across anybody with a baby boy?
Damn. I'm sorry. But no. I haven't run across any kidnapped babies. I'll definitely keep an eye out for him. Anyway... I am glad you're here.
Okay, Preston.
And I hope you don't mind, but I've got another favor to ask. I've had word from a settlement asking for help. There's still hope in there are Minutemen out there, somewhere. The only chance to start rebuilding the Minutemen is to show people that they can count on us when they need us. Trouble is, I've got my hands full here. Do you think you could go help out with the settlement?
I'd be glad to help.
That's fantastic. The Minutemen could use more people like you. By the way, if you want to help out around here at all, talk to Sturgis. I'm sure he'd be glad for all the help he can get.
I am not gonna like when I have to like betray all these people.
Willing to do some work?
I'd be glad to help. Just tell me what you need.
Well, for starters, we could use some real beds. We've been sleeping on the ground for too long. Just make sure we can sleep with a roof over our heads. Some of these old houses still look solid enough to do the trick. There's a workbench over there you can use. Give me a holler if you need anything.
Okay. Sanctuary.
Let's save our fusion cores. There we go. Repair what we can.
You're tied to this.
Okay. We've got a magazine here.
Yes.
I'm gonna use a mod called Raise My Settlement, and I'm going to use it to raise the base settlement. So it's gonna pick up everything instead of me going around picking it all up one by one. And it's gonna put it all in the workshop.
Hey, do you have a moment? I wanted to thank you for helping us out in Concord. If only we'd run into you sooner.
John is very depressing. At least at the start. Sometimes he gets a little less depressing over time. It's almost done. And there's Godsworth.
To this place, kid. Your energy.
And that'll be enough.
I used to live here. A long time ago.
Ah, but the distant past ain't so distant for you. I saw you leave that icebox. This whole world is like some bad dream you can't wake up from, isn't it? The site can help you, kid. It always has answers. Just gotta bring me some jet so I can see what it wants to tell you.
You're an addict. You need help.
Oh, not this again. Kid, listen to me. I'm old, even older than you think. If the Kims are gonna kill me, then I say I've had a good run. We'd have never made it this far without the site. We need it. You need it. It's part of who I am.
The site isn't worth killing yourself over, Mama Murphy. It doesn't have to define what you are.
My charisma's not high enough
yet. My decision, kid, not yours. Now lay off for a while, will ya?
Hey! Hello there! If I'm not mistaken, you're the gal I'm looking for.
Can I help you?
I heard your radio broadcast. Sounded as if you were starting some kind of settlement. Is that about the right of it?
That's right.
Well, in that case, I've got something you might be interested in. Here, catch. It's called an ASAM sensor. If you're gonna be building settlements, these things are what you'll want to use.
Okay. Care to elaborate?
I think a demonstration is in order. Place that ASAM down on the ground somewhere. Go ahead. Any old spot will do.
Sensors for your city planning needs. Unlike other less reliable multi-purpose sensors, Robco brand ASAM sensors offer the level of versatility and connectability that you deserve. Robco brand ASAM sensors, America's number one sensor solution. Distributed in partnership with Voltec.
Nicely done. Don't mind the ASAM, it's just scanning the area for materials. Now for this next part, I'm gonna pretend to be a settler who's come to work for you. So just play along, all right? Boy, I sure am glad I found this settlement to live in. But oh no, there are no homes available. And I don't know how to build one myself. I guess I'll just have to rely on whoever runs this place to build a home for me.
Don't sell yourself short.
You're right. If only I had a little guidance, I could probably build something myself. But wait, what is this? Why, it's an ASAM! Just the thing I need!
What do you need it for?
That is a great question. You see, with an ASAM, there's no barrier for entry when it comes to building something. All I'd need to do is follow the step-by-step instructions provided by the ASAM. Here, let me show you.
The cool thing about this is that
once you place down a sensor,
your
role in the construction is pretty much done. Just about anyone in the settlement can claim the area and start building for themselves. The directions that the ASAM provides are so easy to understand, even a savage could do it with no problem. Just one more nail, and finished.
A man's home is his castle, and no one understands that better than Robco. Our ASAM sensor technology offers citizens unrivaled freedom of DIY home design. Built using locally sourced materials and designed via our patented dynamic easy-build blueprint software. With Robco brand ASAM sensors, everyone can have a roof over their head. After all, a warm and dry citizen is a productive citizen.
And there you have it. A fully built home. Ready for habitation by some lucky wastelander. And you barely had to lift a finger. Not too shabby, huh? So now that you've seen what they can do, what do you think? Are ASAM sensors something you might be interested in?
Yes. I'm really interested.
I thought you might be. Unfortunately, right now I only have the one sensor on me. However, I can provide you with more. And once you have more, I can show you even more stuff you could build with them. Homes are just the start. But first, I'm gonna have to ask for a little task done in return.
Of course. Just tell me what you need help with.
All right, here it is. I got me a workshop in a town called Concord. Nice enough place, fairly quiet. Or at least it was. But just recently, I returned from a trade run to find the entire town overrun by raiders. And now I can't get near my workshop. A small group I could deal with, but there's too many for me to take on alone. So I'm gonna need someone to help take them out.
We already did.
So there it is. That's the job. You help me get rid of these raiders, I'll give you more ASAMs. And show you how to build even more stuff with them.
There's no need to worry. I already took care of those raiders.
You did? Huh. I need to go check this out for myself. Not that I don't believe you, but, you know, I'll meet you outside of Concord Hardware. Then we can discuss your payment.
All right. So now we have to go back to Concord. And we're gonna do that before we finish our quests here. Good reason for that, because what I'm going to do is use a city plan. So first we're gonna get a box of ASAMs from him, and then we can go through the rest of the tutorial for the two different types that he didn't show us. And then after that, he'll go away for a bit, and we can build the city. This way, while we're out adventuring and doing our quests, building something but can't seem to, like, focus on where he's finding it, or he's getting stuck in it or something. I'm trying to see if he's stuck on something, like if he's, like, focused on something I can't see.
Excuse me.
Oh, hey! I'll be honest, when you said you'd already taken care of the Raiders, I had my doubts. But you were speaking the truth. All right. You held up your side of the bargain. The Raiders have been dealt with. Now it's my turn to deliver. If you'd just like to follow me, we'll get you your ASAMs. Welcome to my workshop. Or at least what's left the Raiders didn't smash.
Nice place you got here.
Despite the mess they made, it doesn't look like they took anything important. Most of my equipment is still here. Including your reward. Here. One whole box of ASAMs to do with as you see fit. You earned them.
Happy to help.
That's not all. If you remember, I also promised to show you more things you could build with ASAM sensors. I'll meet you back at your settlement. Don't keep me waiting long now.
And back to Sanctuary we go. Okay. So the other two types we need to see now are industrial and agricultural.
You're tied to this place, kid. Your energy.
Hey there.
Alright, time to show you what else ASAMs can do. Now, generally speaking,
people
need a roof over their heads, food in their bellies, and a place to be working. We already built a place someone could live. So if you're ready, let's move on to those other two things.
Okay. Show me.
Alright. Place down a sensor again. But this time, we'll use one configured for food production. Okay, I'm gonna take on the role of a settler again. Don't worry, I won't subject you to my bad theatrics this time. I just want to show you how easy this is. Now, I can't say I've got much of a green thumb, but thanks to the ASAM, that don't really matter. tell your settlers where to dig, what to plant, when to harvest. Takes out all the guesswork. No fuss, no muss. Well, maybe a little bit of muss. I mean, I am getting covered
that
in dirt.
That deathlong conquered was
but how's
bad
that
news,
different
huh?
to any other day in the Commonwealth?
Ever seen one of those fuckers before?
Oh, sure. Plenty. One time, I killed a deathlong all by myself.
Okay.
No
almost done.
On a fancy minigun. Just a pipe pistol. One bullet.
You telling me you killed a deathclaw with one bullet? Come on. What do you take me for?
It's true. I might not look it, but back in the day, I had quite the shot.
Yeah, or quite the imagination.
Yes! Gone are the days of citizens complaining over those ever-increasing grocery store prices, thanks to Rocker Brand ASAM sensors. Never has it been easier for citizens to grow their own mouth-watering produce. It's so simple, even the wife and kids will want to get their hands dirty. For the finest in homegrown food, look to Rocker Brand ASAM sensors.
And there we have it. A fine plot of land ready for cultivation. This from the guy who once underwatered a cactus.
I like it.
Glad to hear. All right, we've built a home, a farm. Next thing is a place to work. You know, somewhere folks can perform a little industry. Gather scrap or do a bit of scavenging, that kind of thing. Go ahead, put down an ASAM that's programmed for that.
We're gonna put it right over here.
Okay, time for some industrial action. I'm on it. Looks like the sensors pre-selected a storage unit to build. That'll be useful. Any old fool can gather a pile of junk. But if you want settlements to grow, you need folks to gather useful building materials. And a storage unit will encourage people to do that. Wood, steel, maybe even a little asbestos to help keep warm. And don't be surprised if in time people start gathering even more useful stuff. Through now. Hide it tight. And we're done.
Pretty cool, eh? I love this system. If you want to know more about sim settlements too, I would suggest looking up King Gath. K-I-N-G-G-A-D-H. Or just look up some settlements too on the internet.
Time's not tough. There's no bones about it. Even useful people are starting to feel the pinch. But you can rely on Rocco to provide fulfilling employment alternatives. With just one handy-dandy Rocco brand ASAM sensor, citizens need never fear unemployment again. Able to legally gather and store useful materials, your citizens will wonder how they ever did without a Rubco industrial unit. Just one more in the long line of technological marvels brought to you by Rubco Brand ASAM sensors.
Well, there we are. All basic necessities covered. Although folks won't be happy with the bare essentials forever. Eventually, they will want more. Now, it's up to you what type of ASAMs you put down, but do try and keep in mind what folks in your settlements will be needing.
Excuse me, hello. Don't shoot now, I don't mean no harm. I hope you don't mind the intrusion. I couldn't help but notice all the commotion. What are you two youngins up to here? That is, if you don't mind me asking. Fixing up these buildings, are you?
Yeah, something like that.
Actually, we just finished building these. Foundations, walls, everything.
Is that so? Built them by yourself, did you? Well, you two looking to settle down here, or...?
This settlement belongs to my friend here, not me. I was just demonstrating some construction techniques using this ASAM sensor.
Construction techniques? Using that gadget there? Sounds like Brahmin dung to me. Are you telling me you made all this using that gizmo?
That's right. We're rebuilding.
You say that as if building stuff is easy.
Hey, here's a suggestion. Why not offer the old-timer residents here? Let them experience the benefits of sensors firsthand. That is, if you'd be interested in staying here.
I'll admit, seeing you two build with those doodads did pique my curiosity. And it might be nice to settle down somewhere for a while. It is getting dangerous out there, especially for a scab past his prime. But would an old man like me really be welcome here?
I'd welcome the help.
Okay then, you got yourself a deal. Old Paul is at your service. Now if you'd excuse me a second, I want to check out this here sensor doohickey.
How about that? Your ASAMs have already attracted their first resident. With that, I'd say our exchange of services is complete. Enjoy your ASAMs. I'm sure you'll put them to good use. Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta get back to the hardware store. Got a lot of important work to begin on with.
What kind of work?
I've got some family matters I need to take care of. Personal stuff. I'm sure you understand.
It was good working with you.
Yeah, you too. I should get going. Oh, and good luck with your settlement.
Hey, where's that ASAM fella going? I wanted to ask him a few questions.
Well, if something's wrong, maybe I can help.
Maybe you could. You're the head honcho around this place, right? Well, I've got a request to make. You see, I noticed that there's a whole bunch of new people around here, so I'm thinking it might be best to put down a few more of these here censored thingamabobs. You know, to make sure everybody's got a home, a place to work, and not to mention enough food.
Very honcho-y. That's a good idea.
Well, I've been known to have a decent idea now and again. These ASAM things seem very impressive, but we can only make use of them if you place them down for us.
So, now we are going to go ahead and use a city plan. So, we're taking out a city planner's task. Now we're going to pick which city plan to use. I'm missing some blocks. I don't want to use the raider place. Let's use the waning sanctuary. That's very pretty. Alright. Now we need to choose a mayor.
I'm sorry, I wouldn't be very good company right now.
So,
into a settlement to be proud of.
And enjoy.